Hi, Tracy Hugelmeyer here from VintagePreneurUniversity.com, where I help vintage sellers start, grow, and scale their business on Etsy. And I also own my own vintage business on Etsy that I've had since 2013. And today I'm so super excited to jump right back into our Friday feedbacks. I've been away for a little while and I just wanted to kind of talk about that for just a moment. Because I think it's important that you share, you know, not only the highs in your life, but sometimes the lows when that's appropriate too, because we're all going through things in life and, you know, sometimes we can talk about them and other times we can't. Everybody has things that they're struggling with. And, you know, if you have something that you're struggling with right now and you're feeling like you can't move forward, I just want you to know that, you know, you can, you just have to kind of wade through it a little bit. And that's kind of where I was the last few weeks. You know, I was going through my son deploying for the first time. And it kind of struck me harder than I expected it to. And it's partly where he's going and it's partly, just the unknown. And of course that he's my baby and all of those things. But, it was difficult. And every time that I tried to jump on here and do another video, or I didn't actually even get that far, I just felt like I couldn't, you know, I didn't have it in me to do that. And so I'm really happy to be back here and doing these videos for you. But if you're watching this right now and, you know, this is something you need to hear, I hope that you are listening to this video right now, that if you are going through something and you feel like you can't move forward in your business, hang in there, you know, get help if you need to, but when you're ready, you'll be able to pick yourself back up and get going. And that's really what matters most, that you just keep moving forward. And if you need someone to talk to help get you through that lull in your business, you know, don't ever hesitate to reach out to me. You can always contact me at tracy@therusticeye.com. But regardless, hang in there, you can do this. Okay, so before I introduce you to today's Friday feedback volunteer, a quick disclaimer that no matter who you're getting advice from, you never want to go into your shop and change everything at once. You want to be very mindful of the changes that you make so that you can keep a handle on what's working, what's not working. And you always want to do that internal check to make sure that the changes you're making are in line with your brand and they're the best business decision for you and your Etsy vintage shop. Okay, so if you're wondering how you can get your own free review for your shop like this one I'm about to give, you just need to become an Etsy junkie, and I show you how to do that in the notes below. So check that out. All right, so here we are in Phoebe's vintage shop, Vintage Metals Reborn, and I will link to her shop below so you can go check that out as well. And I just love when you first land on her page, this kind of look into the past window banner that she has. I think it's super cute and it coordinates perfectly with her little photo here too. And I'm not sure if it's on purpose, but it's perfect for Valentine's Day because of the hearts, hearts here, hearts here. I'm guessing she probably redoes this photo for the holidays, which is super smart. So it's really looking festive and you get that feeling right away when you land here. And then I also loved that she put this free shipping little note here, because even though Etsy does put that on our individual listings, they do play around with what that looks like. So sometimes, I don't know if you've noticed, but sometimes they have the little tag, like they have free shipping, but here's an item under $18. And it used to be that they would have a little banner here that said, or some wording here or something to the effect of free shipping eligible, but I don't see that right now. But if you click on it, you can see that it's got the little jumping truck here, which I do like. The enjoy free shipping to the US when you spend 35 plus at this shop. So that's really clear, but it's not so much clear on your homepage today, at least. You know, that could change tomorrow. I kind of wish on my wish list is that Etsy would put some kind of banner on the shop, something to the effect of, you know, what we saw with that truck, but at the top of your shop, so it's really clear. I think that would be a smart thing for them to do. I just might send that suggestion over. But putting it in your banner is smart. I think I'm going to copy that, Phoebe. I like that a lot. And again, you can see this is coordinating with her whole theme of the gingham, the red and white gingham and the hearts. Super cute. And then she goes on to showcase some of her items, which is really smart. I would recommend that you switch these out as you update things and have new things to sell. Not all the time necessarily, but just so it's representing a good, you know, a good representation of what you have available in your shop. I do notice that Phoebe has Etsy Plus, which I have plenty of videos that go into my thoughts on Etsy Plus. But one nice thing about it is it does give you a lots of space to showcase what you have. I'll link below to my video on Etsy Plus too, just because I'm mentioning that in case you want to take a look. Okay, so next right here in your shop title, I think those are all really good keywords. I would recommend combining a couple of them just because vintage in itself isn't really a good search term because so many things would come up if you searched for vintage because it's so general. But if you changed this to, for example, vintage retro jewelry and MCM rustic decor or something like that, whatever you want your 2 to 3 keyword phrases to be that represent most clearly what you sell for your shop, that's what I would recommend here. You want to think in search in terms of searchable terms, okay? And then same with your items, or your section titles here. These also should be searchable terms. And both the shop title and the searchable terms, as far as we know, Etsy does not look at those as when they are trying to figure out who to send to your shop, but the outside search engines like Google do look at that, those areas, and really everywhere on our site. So having searchable terms helps kind of let those outside search engines know what it is you have to offer and who, and therefore they can figure out who to send to your shop. So if you're if you list things that are searchable terms, you'll have more of a chance of getting found from an outside search engine perspective. So that said, industrial decor is a really good search term. Christmas and holidays, because it's so vague, I would probably recommend that you put vintage Christmas decor or vintage Christmas ephemera, or since that's what you have right now, all Christmas. And then if you want to change it to, you know, vintage Valentine's Day, you can do that, as long as you have enough space, of course, in the little section. But basically, you just want to make these terms searchable terms. So vintage religious coins. This, I mean, you could even get very specific because that's what you mostly have here, vintage religious coins, etc. Or, I mean, if you can fit that, something like that, because if somebody is searching religious, they may not land on your shop, but if they're searching for vintage religious coins, then that's a much more specific search term. Hopefully that makes sense. And sorry, I think these would be called metals and not coins. Forgive my mistake there. Okay, hopping down to your announcement. I can see that you have the enjoy free purchase or free shipping on total purchases of $35 or more showing on top. And I think that's probably strategic that you did that. Normally, I would recommend that you put, you know, your keywords, your main keyword phrases, those 2 to 3 main keyword phrases at the very beginning of your announcement. And that's just for those outside search engines, again, to reinforce what it is that you have for sale in your shop. But since you may be being completely strategic with that, maybe just move this up a little bit, you know, put some thought into what you want those top 2 to 3 keyword phrases to be, and then repeat them in your shop title and your announcement and also in your about section and other places in your shop. But once you figure that out, then maybe just move that up a little bit. If you want to keep this peaking at the top, it's probably not horrible if, you know, it's not the very first thing you say, but you also, and by the very first thing, I mean your keyword phrases, but You also want to say them in a natural way written for humans, which is what you do here, so that's perfect. Vintage Metals Reborn sells vintage farmhouse and mid-century pieces, everything from designer jewelry to antique stove legs. That's all good. Remember to kind of combine things. So maybe even vintage farmhouse and mid-century pieces will be better than putting a separator between vintage and farmhouse, because that way if someone searches for vintage farmhouse, then it's more likely to land them on your shop. So yeah, just move that up a little bit, and I would put this down below your keyword phrases at a minimum, but otherwise I think that looks really good. So many really great reviews, and I don't know if you guys have noticed lately, but I feel like I've seen that Etsy, so I've gotten a couple, and they were mistakes, just as a side note, and the customers ended up changing how many stars they gave me, but they initially gave me a 3-star, and Etsy hit it, which I thought was really interesting. They put it wasn't the top review. They kind of pushed it back, and it makes sense because it's in Etsy's best interest to showcase shops in the best possible light. So I'm wondering if there's some kind of, something in their algorithm, not their search algorithm, but the way that they show these reviews to kind of say, okay, well, if the average is greater than blah, 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 well, then hide that bad review, something like that. So not that they're being dishonest with somebody who might land on their shop, but they're giving them the benefit of the doubt that usually they have good reviews and they want that to shine. So I don't know, comment below, let me know what you guys have seen, but I've seen this a few times now where Etsy seems to kind of put the, even though they were mistakes, those, the reviews that weren't 5-stars, they kind of got buried a little bit, and I just thought that was interesting. Okay, and the other thing while we're talking about reviews, even though it's kind of a side note, definitely make sure if you have something that seems abnormal, like if somebody says, a really nice comment, but then they give you 3 stars, reach out to them and just say, I really appreciate your feedback. Is there something I can do to, you know, it's always I always strive to make sure that my customers have a 5-star experience. So please let me know if there's anything that I can do to change that for you, or something like that. If you do that, then chances are, it was a mistake and they're going to update it. So that's just kind of like a side note tip. I've seen that happen more often recently where somebody will accidentally leave lower stars than they meant to. And so just pay attention to that and don't be afraid to nicely and professionally reach out to someone if something seems amiss, because it is your business after all, right? And if I didn't say it already, 827 sales since 2016. Wow, you're doing an awesome job. You should be super, super proud of that, Phoebe. I also enjoyed your about story. I really think that having an about story, or just a story in general, your about section, your story, mixing the terms, it really helps to kind of set you apart and define your brand and what makes you special. And I think that you have a lot of that in your about section in your story. I would even recommend maybe adding a little bit more of your story visually. So if you have a picture of your 1940s house, I would love to see that in your about story, just a suggestion, because I think that's really cool. And so anything like that I think would be really cool to add to kind of visually add to your story. Yay for using the template for the shop policies and having those all filled out. By anyone who doesn't know what I mean by the template, prior to, maybe like 2015, 2016, maybe even 2017, sellers had the option of kind of using their own policies, and then they adopted a template, which they recommended that everybody update to, but they didn't require it at the time. But if you came in after a certain time, after they pushed out those new that new policy template, you didn't have a choice. So you had to use the template. But the reason I'm bringing this up is because if you use the Etsy policies template and you have them filled out, then Etsy has told us that that will give us a boost in search results. So definitely you want to do that if you're not already doing it. And I recommend that you always fill everything out that you have available to you, every space that Etsy gives us, so that your shop looks complete. And not only does it look complete and that's appealing to buyers who might land on your shop, but it also is telling Etsy that you're serious about your business and they definitely want to see, they want to promote serious businesses, is what it comes down to. Love that you're accepting returns, exchanges, and cancellations. I always recommend that. I do also like to note that if you aren't selling one of these things, like if you are never going to sell food or flowers or perishable products, you can remove that just to clean up your policies a little bit. It's kind of like a minor thing. It's not a must do, but just to keep it relevant to your business. That's something you can consider. And lots of FAQs, which I love to see. There's a few reasons for that. One, it helps to answer your customers' questions. And whenever you can do that and jump in front of any questions or concerns that they might have, you're more likely to convert somebody who's browsing your shop or your items to a sale. And two, it's a great place to bring in your brand personality. So really great when you do that. You just always want to keep your FAQs professional, upbeat. You don't want to use it as a place to say, I'm not going to do this and I'm not going to do that. I know we've all seen those types of policies and FAQs. Don't be one of those shops, because it's not helping you in the least when you have that kind of an attitude in your business. I mean, just think about it from an outsider perspective. If you were shopping in a shop and they were like kind of just acting like they didn't care so much about you, that would affect you whether you would buy from that shop or not, most likely. So just keep that in mind. But I love a couple things about Phoebe's FAQs. One, they're really easy to get through because of how she uses the asterisks. That's a hard word to say. And then also, they're very upbeat. And he's like, here you can see customer satisfaction is my top priority. Please convo me with any questions or concerns. I usually respond within a few minutes. That's great. These are all great things to have in your FAQs. And even this little disclaimer about vintage and pre-owned, I've seen this a lot in vintage shops. I think it's completely fine to have and probably a good idea. But the way that Phoebe words it is very positive and professional. And if you're looking for an example of how to say this in a good way, I would say go look at Phoebe's shop. She says, as my items are vintage before 2000, they have considerable age to them and have been pre-owned, used, or worn. I do my best to point out any flaws they may have, but some small things may be missed. Please bear this in mind when purchasing and feel free to contact me with any questions. So that's very professional, very to the point, and very, upbeat and polite, which does the job, right? And one more thing before we move on, because I really liked this. I will not hesitate to refund the cost of the item. If it arrives broken, convo me as soon as possible. She's, again, reassuring her buyers that if they buy from her, they can trust that they'll have a good experience. She's doing that in many ways. And that's what you want to try and accomplish, really, from the whole tone of your shop. You want your buyers, your customers, your browsers, whatever, to feel confident, to alleviate any concerns that they might have, and to feel comfortable making that purchase from you. So everything you should do should be with that in mind. Okay, so for the item that I'm choosing to review, I'm picking these cute little salt and pepper shakers, or actually pepper and sugar shakers. And what I thought was really cool about this, before I get to the full review, is Phoebe does something really unique, at least unique from what I've seen, and that is she offers them separately and also together. So if you buy just the pepper shaker or just the sugar shaker, it's $25, but if you buy both, you get a pretty good discount at $40. So that does a few things. It gives the buyer or browser options, and options are always a good thing because it's kind of a psychology hack that if somebody has an option to buy something that more suits their needs, then they may be more likely to make that purchase. So if someone's looking at this and they really only want the sugar one, but they don't want to spend $40 for just the sugar one, but they see, hey, I can buy just the sugar shaker for $25, then they might be willing to do that. Or vice versa, if they are looking at just the sugar shaker, but then they see that this adorable matching pepper shaker, they might be willing to spend that extra $15 to get both. So that's a really good technique. I love that you're trying that. I noticed that you have some other sets that you don't do this with. I'm wondering if it's something that you're experimenting with. Definitely comment, Phoebe, if you get a chance, and let us know how that's going for you. I'm guessing that is working in your benefit. I could see this working really well for maybe things like china sets too, or if you have some kind of jewelry set that, you know, you've been considering piecing out, but you think that, hey, maybe it will be more appealing if I sell it as a set. Well, why not try offering it as both, like Phoebe does here? And the only thing is, you have to be very on top of if the both shake, or if one of them sell, then you have to go in and remove that other option. So you have to be on top of that. But I don't see that being a huge issue. Just make sure you have your notifications turned on for your sales. You're getting those cha-chings so that you need to check and see if you need to edit anything, and then you can go in and do that really quick once you get the sale. I would say that that's no different really than cross-listing something, say on Etsy and eBay, where if something sells, you have to go in and make an adjustment somewhere really quick. All right, so let's take a look at your photos. I think you have a lot of really great photos showing a lot of the detail. Including, you know, some of the, maybe what some people would be consider, you know, an imperfection, inside, really everything you could need to know about or would want to know about these. So I think you do a really good job there. I don't know if there are any marks on the bottom, but if so, you might want to show the bottom or even just show the bottom regardless in case somebody's like a collector and they're looking for a certain mark. And the only other suggestion I have for your photos is try experimenting with getting on eye level with your items. So instead of kind of, it looks a little bit here like you're going, you know, looking from above a little bit, try getting down just a little bit, or putting your platform up a little bit so that you're taking your photographs at eye level, and see if that makes any difference for you. Not a huge deal, but just something that you might play with to see if it gives you a little bit of a better angle for your front photo there. Once you get past the first photo, the photos, you know, the angles, those types of things, they aren't really as important. See, this is a little bit more at eye level. So just getting down a little bit so you get that eye level view would be my recommendation for a front photo, meaning your first photo, the first one that people see in a search, and that you want to do everything you can to grab their attention. Eye level is usually best for that, unless you're doing like a flat lay or some other type of photography. So yeah, eye level for your front photo, and then maybe the bottom of these just to show if there are any markings or not would be my only suggestions for photos. But good job showing a lot of different angles here and a lot of different, pieces of information that one might be interested in for these cute shakers. All right, so as far as your item title, I think it looks really good. You're covering a lot of keywords here. And again, when it comes to your titles. You just want to think in terms of how people are going to be looking for your, searching for your item, right? So, whereas I probably wouldn't search, most people probably wouldn't search for retro black white rain shakers. Those are all still really good keywords. And I did a little test, and I searched for it in a search to see kind of what I thought of searching for. So I typed in vintage sugar shaker, and sure enough, your items are right there on the front page out of 2,419 results. So that's really awesome. You definitely are getting found, which is what it boils down to. You need to make sure you have keywords that people are searching for that you're going to be found. So great job there. And just a little side note, keep in mind that the bigger your competition, the more important keywords become. So if you have something that's really, really niche, then you might not have to work as hard for keywords. You just might need to get a little creative on how to attract more traffic to that niche item. But if you have something that's super, super mainstream and is all over Etsy, then that's when keywords become, you know, a little bit more important. I would probably put vintage sugar shaker or vintage sugar shaker and vintage pepper shaker at the start of your title. But again, that's a minor thing because, like I just showed you, you're being found anyway with a, you know, a common search term. I love that you put black white kitchen. I would probably add farmhouse in here if you don't already have it somewhere, because it's definitely something. Yep, you have it right here. Farmhouse kitchen. That's excellent because it's definitely something that you would find in a farmhouse kitchen. And while we're down here in your tags, we'll go ahead and take a look at those. I think they look really good. You've got a lot of varied search terms here. And the only thing you might not need is to repeat things so often. So for example, if you want to make more space, instead of saying shabby kitchen, rustic kitchen, farmhouse kitchen, you could do something like shabby rustic kitchen and then farmhouse gift or whatever. Basically, what I'm trying to suggest here is you can open up more space by combining some of these keywords. You don't have to repeat the words so often if you don't want to. It's not going to hurt you, but like if you're trying to add more keywords, that's one way to combine them and get more space for that. I also love that you include a gift. Vintage kitchen gift is even, you could even add something like gift for new homeowner or new homeowner gift or something like that. To try and give some search term, add some search terms that people would be looking for gifts. But vintage kitchen gift is really good too. So those all look really good. And when now to onto your description. So I noticed that you have still have some sale information in there. You definitely want to make sure you go and take that out. I totally get that. I had my shipping deadlines, my holiday deadlines in my listings past Christmas too. I just took them out not that long ago. So totally get you there. But just a note to make sure you go in there and take those out. Just do a bulk edit and, you know, search for those phrases and you should be good to go and get those out. So you explain here, that's good, that this is listing for one or both of the shakers. Please see drop down menu to see options. A nice pair of vintage Hazel Atlas milk glass range top shakers with black wording and graphics. I would put this at the top of your description because you have those great keyword searchable phrases there. That you want to make sure that you're putting first and foremost on your listing descriptions for those outside search engines like Google. But otherwise, and then, you know, you can add this right underneath it and take those out. And I think that would be great. You do a really good job of describing the condition and the measurements, and adding more keyword phrases. That's always a good idea. Keywords in throughout your description, so that you can, again, optimize for outside search engines. I would recommend, a couple things here. I see that you have the seller platform link. This is not a huge issue, but just something I like to point out, because this is the link that you see internally, but it's not an external link. Now, Etsy has made it so that if you click on it, it's still going to go. I'm not signed in right now. I'm in a incognito window, and it still takes me to the right place. So it's more just a visual point, because let me get back to where I want it to be. Because just so it's just more just a visual thing. So it doesn't say seller platform. So the way you do that is make sure you're signed out of your account. You could go into an incognito window if you want, but just make sure you're signed out of your account and then copy the link, and then it won't say seller platform. Not a huge deal, just something that to note. And other than that, I think that you are doing a really good job in your description of including everything that you need to include. It's always a good idea to, you know, give some suggestions of how somebody might use this. So you do say a kitchen display. You could mention something about it would be a great gift for a new homeowner who loves farmhouse kitchens or something like that. Just to give more suggestions. The point being that whenever you can help somebody visualize how something can be used in their own home or how they can give it as a gift, then you increase your chances of converting that browser to a buyer and getting the sale. Same thing goes with photos. If you can include like a lifestyle photo, that's something that you can consider. And that's just maybe showing these up on a shelf in a kitchen or something like that, which again is to help the browser, your customers, visualize it in their home. Ready to ship in one business day. That's excellent. That is definitely helping you with your conversions, because I do know that this is not a possibility for everyone, but whenever you can ship quickly, that's going to help you get those sales. So good job there, Phoebe. Oh, the last thing I wanted to say is, instead of saying maybe for additional vintage items, maybe make it a little bit more personal, as far as making it clear that it's, you know, your shop. And so think about somebody browsing on Etsy and they land on your thing, and they're not going to know that if you say for additional vintage items, they may not know that that's going to take them back to your items. And they might just think that, you know, it's going to show them other vintage items on Etsy. So you've already captured their attention at this point, right? They found your item in a search, we'll just say, and you want to let them know that you have more, you know, kitchen items like this, vintage kitchen items that are great for farmhouse lovers, we'll just say. So you could say something like, thank you for visiting Vintage Metals Reborn. Check out all, more awesome vintage kitchen items here, or check out more of my amazing vintage farmhouse decor here. And whatever it relates to, you could send them back to your shop. You could send them back to one of your sections, or you could even send them to some coordinating items if you have them. So like, let's say you had a matching larger jar or something, you could say, you check out the coordinating, flower jar here or something like that. Just giving some clarity to help capture their attention and keep them in your shop and keep them engaged with you. So that's the objective there. So I hope that was helpful, Phoebe. You're doing a great job. You're touching on a lot of the important points already. It's just a matter of, you know, making small improvements here and there and, you know, doing that at a pace that's comfortable for you and makes sense for your business. Hopefully you picked up some tips there. Thank you so, so much for joining me today. You can, again, find out how to get your own free review in the notes below. You just have to become an Etsy junkie. And number two, you got to sell vintage on Etsy. So I look forward to your review as well. And again, thank you for joining me today. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.